here's the thing. My favorite story of all time is Pistorius.
Oh, yes, yes.
The runner.
Tell who Pistorius is.
Well, you know who Pistorius is.
No, but for the viewers that don't know.
Who doesn't know?
Well, the viewers that don't know.
South African gentleman.
Well, some viewers don't know. Well, he should tell it to some of the viewers who don't know who Pistorius is.
He's an Olympic runner who ran with blades. Everyone knows who he is.
Well, I wouldn't say ran with blades.
I didn't ask you what you would say right now.
That's true. I am off
drugs. Okay, listen.
After the show, I'm going to start.
Pistorius grew up as a kid without legs, which is tough.
Yes.
Okay? His whole life, he's made fun of. All of a sudden, he gets blades. He becomes the hero of the world, makes millions of dollars, meets the most beautiful woman in the history of life, and shoots her, but comes up with the lamest excuse I've ever heard
in my
life.
What was his excuse?
He said he was standing on the balcony on his stumps. Beside the bed were his two legs and this gorgeous woman in the bed. Now, if I'm a burglar, I'm breaking in for two reasons. One, to rape a woman, and two, to rob everything. So if I come in there and I see, Jesus Christ, I got legs I can take her, I'm gonna do up. No, I'm not. I'm gonna go into the bathroom, lock myself in, and take a good, healthy dump. What kind of an excuse is that?
You're right. It's a weak alibi.
It's so weak. Yeah. And he said he didn't know where his wife, his girlfriend was. The toilet is a foot away.
Yeah.
Wouldn't you notice if she's in bed or not?
Of course. So what's the number one reason you'd break into a house?
Yeah, I want to go over that again.
I don't break into a house. I said number one reason that someone goes into a house is they either rape someone or steal something. Okay?
Yeah, I
have. And this guy found a gold mine. But he decided to take a shit instead. Doesn't make sense, does it? And what about that dormer, this guy who killed the cops?
Yeah, explain to the folks.
I don't want to explain anything. If you're going to say that after everything I say, I'm going to leave.
No, I've heard people say that.
This is the cheapest thing I've ever been involved in.
No, I've heard people say that.
If I didn't love you, I would be so gone now. I can't tell you.
I've heard people say that. Explain to the folks who that is.
Dormer.
Dorner, yes, Christopher Dorner.
Yeah. Okay.
Explain
He's
to the folks who he was.
Tall.
He was the African-American
police
officer.
Guy. His arms are like this. He can't take a bad picture. Even his mugshot was great. He goes and decides to hide in Big Bear.
Yeah.
He's the only black man in Big Bear, and he was there for 6 days. What, was he going to the market with nose glasses? Are you Christopher Dorner? No, sir. No, but you look like him. No. And then after they killed him, the police were giving the story, and behind them the house was burning, and they said, is Dorner inside? We don't know. We're not sure. So you're just killing someone and burning their house, and then you'll find out later.
Maybe he's taking a dump.
Hey, did you read his
manifesto? Yeah.
You know, I went to a tennis match in Indian Wells.
Yeah.
And I saw Rafael Nadal play. He's my favorite.
Rafael Nadal. Explain to the folks who Rafael Nadal is.
Oh, my God.
No, Nadal. I'll explain. Okay. Rafael Nadal is a tennis player, only 26, but seemingly beyond his prime.
Great player.
Abs like...
Great player, but here's the thing.
You like his abs?
Every single time he serves and returns, he picks his underwear out of his ass.
He does?
Yes.
I've never heard
that. There's a video of it. Show it. I brought it.
There's a video of that?
Yes, I brought it.
Well, how could that...
Can we roll that off the schneid?
What?
My fiddlehead.
It's too much bread and butter.
You can't see that in public.
This man is a genius.
Lord, that's all he does.
What if he was a dentist? Hello?
Oh.
Hello?
Oh, he smelled it.
Oh, what was that all about? Yeah.